Hi guys, welcome to another episode from the PASSCOM training video series. Today we're going to be taking a look at the topic of updating and backing up your on-site solution. We will also touch a little bit on cloud solutions for backups, but the updates...
We do the job in the cloud solution, for some reasons, do a backup in the cloud solution as well.
Basically, the boss man is up all night doing the updates for everybody in the cloud.
Or migration.
Exactly. But we're actually going to focus predominantly on on-site solutions. So whether you've got a virtual PBX or you've got an appliance from us, this is the way to update your platform and also to back up your platform. Matthias, are there some things that we need to know about first?
Yes, so first we talk about the update. Mm-hmm. That's easy. You can go to our website and download the latest ISO file, which maybe you did already for the initial setup, or you got the appliance, but anyhow, here is the download and here you can get the latest ISO file. If you have the latest ISO file, you can go to the management, which is 8443, the port, and then you can to the management, where you can manage everything. Maybe you know this already, and this is
the phone system.
The phone system itself with /PASSCOM in this case. What to do, how to apply the update? You go to system, you go to upload update, and here you just browse the ISO file. So here are our downloads, the ISO file, open it and upload. It does the upload. I can cancel it.
Yeah,
you can imagine how this looks like.
Yeah, exactly.
At some point in time, it reaches 100%.
Yeah, but there is one thing to perhaps be aware of here. Like when you do an update, it doesn't happen very often, but if it goes wrong, we always store the older version of the software so you can always refer back to it.
Yes.
It doesn't happen often at all, but just in case.
Just in case.
We have that.
System AB on the hard drive, and at boot you can choose from A or B. Mm-hmm. Normally it goes to whatever was updated, and then you can just go in the boot menu and choose the other one if something is broken.
And also the second thing to note is that the update isn't automatic. You actually have to sort of start it yourself, don't you?
Yes.
Yeah, because you know telephony being a real-time live service, that would be a little bit.
So for sure, not if the update, the upload is done, then it reboots immediately and does everything. No, you can then say now, do it. If you say don't do it now, then it does it at next reboot.
Yeah. Okay. Good.
So, but that's it. The update is very easy.
Simple.
Simple. You upload the ISO file and the system does the rest. It also updates your instances. So it does update the management, the OS, mm-hmm. security fixes also for the OS, so you don't have to care about that, and also for your phone instance. So everything is one update and does it automatically.
This is important for both customers and partners, but more relevant for the partners who actually do hosting from PASSCOM, because they can, in the management UI, they can have multiple phone systems.
Yes.
A customer can have two, I think.
Yes, two, but one running.
Yeah.
No, as many as he like, but one running.
Exactly. Whereas our partners, the hosting partners, can have as many as they like running, give or take. And once you do the update, all those instances on that particular host are updated as well.
Yes. Yeah. Per default. Yeah. You can do it another way around, but per default it's like that.
Yeah, okay, good.
Yes, so that's the update part. If you're in the cloud, you don't have to care about it because there is an update plan and we do the updates regularly through the maintenance windows. Mm-hmm. I think they are from 2 to 6.
Something like that.
Whatever.
When I'm in bed.
Yeah, that's true. When you are in bed, that's true. And then everything is done for you. But here, if you're on site, you have to care about that.
Okay, good. So what's next?
Next is how do we do a backup?
Okay.
Again, maybe we start with the cloud users. Mm-hmm. As a cloud user, you are only in here because you have your PASSCOM.cloud /whatever your instance name is, and then you're in your management mm-hmm. or in your phone system. Here you have the ability to go here and say, you want to make a backup, you can say include recordings, include faxes, include voicemails. It's all set to no.
Yep. Why is that?
Because it can get big.
Very quick, very quickly.
Not so for the faxes. Mm-hmm. Maybe if you're a massive fax fan.
If you're a German company that just loves faxes, then fair enough. But
yes.
No. Yeah, anyway.
But voicemails can also get big and for sure the recordings.
Yeah, but there's also another reason why these are set for no as default. Not only did they get big, but for example, voicemails, the default setting of the Pascom phone system is to send voicemails per email.
Correct.
Yes. So you've already got them somewhere redundantly stored.
Same for faxes. They're already sent to you via email.
Exactly.
Maybe you don't care about which is stored on the server still.
Yeah, so you don't necessarily need to have two copies at that
point.
Call recordings a little bit different depending on your dispatch mode, but that is something to be aware of on that front.
Yes, you can then do it. It does it while the system is running in background, and it's relatively quick. Okay, this is an empty system.
Yeah.
But also, if you have data in there, it's not that much bigger. You can download it now here. And you get your backup from your instance. Now you can ask, why should I? I'm a cloud customer. The whole system has guaranteed uptime and there are backups. Sure, we do backups. If something goes wrong, we can restore your system. But for which case is not? If you want to do a huge change on your configuration, maybe you want to do a backup first, you do the configuration, and then you upload the backup if something was wrong.
Yeah.
If you test new importers, for instance, big phone books, you import all your users. You change something when you want to import your users, and accidentally you delete all your users because you did it wrong in the importer. Shit happens.
Yeah, it does.
So you can make a backup. This is the one reason why you could do it also as a cloud customer. The other reason is you want to migrate.
Okay.
So you want maybe to cancel this subscription and create another one. Mm-hmm. Or you move your company from one to the other. Or this is your customer because you're a partner and you want to move it from one partner, from one customer to the other because the customer is renaming his company.
Rebranding, merger, whatever it could be.
Whatever. So there are reasons you want the data from your instance and you want to create a new one. Several reasons.
Rather than starting from
then
scratch.
This is the way you go. And then if you create a new instance, you can choose this screen where you can say start from backup.
Exactly, yeah.
And then you can just upload the backup from there.
If you haven't seen that screen before, I'm sure you have, but if you haven't, then it's in the initial setup video.
Yes.
So you can have a look at that and that will tell you exactly what to do. It's very straightforward. You just press yes, basically.
Yes, yes and yes.
And upload yes.
Yes.
There we go. So good. Now on the on-premise side of things, this process from here is fairly similar.
Yeah, you can do it like this, but then it's just 30%. Yeah, it depends because here is the configuration. We could say it's 80%.
Okay.
Because this is the work which is done.
Can you automate this?
You can automate this, and if you are on site, and you can backup it from outside. I will show this.
Okay.
You can go here to the phone system. This is your phone system, which is running. It's just one. You can add multiple and then just start one. But if you're a CSP partner, then you have multiple here. And you can go to details. And here you can create the backup of the running machine in the background. And it collects the job here. And then you can download this file and store it somewhere else. So you can really back up your phone system.
Yeah.
You can automate this part if you like. We have a tool on the shell, so you log in with SSH. We have a tool which is called CS for Cloud Stack.
Okay.
And there you can do exactly the same as you can do in the UI. You can say create a backup, then it creates the backup, and then you can with SCP just copy it away. So you can automate.
So for hosting, CSP partners.
Hosting, or if you have a virtual machine. And normally, if you have a virtual machine, you will back up the whole virtual machine and that's it.
Yeah.
You have a solution for this in most cases, but you can do this in addition. And you can automate it with the CS command on the shell. Then there is another thing you have to know is these are just the phone systems. What do I need to backup if I don't have a backup of the whole system because it's a VMware? What do I have? What do I have to keep? And there is only one thing you have to keep from the system around your phone system, and that's here. If you go to your interfaces, and then is here the provisioning key. This is the provisioning key which is used to hash all the, or to encrypt all the provisioning stuff. If so you lose this key, then the phones cannot do the provisioning, hardware phones. And if you want to really, so they still work because they have the configuration, mm-hmm. but you cannot use the URL to update them uh-huh. any longer because it does not fit to the system. So if you want to have a complete backup, if you have no solution around like Veeam for VMware or whatever, mm-hmm. then just store this key. Then if you crash the complete machine, you can just do a nicer setup.
Okay.
Make the configuration of the IP address, mm-hmm. put your certificates in place again, and add this provisioning key, and then you're done. And then you can import your PBXs to the system.
Okay, again. And then everything works as it did before.
Yes.
Hopefully, touch wood.
Yes.
Yeah, it will do.
It will do if you did not do a mistake.
Yes, fair enough. Good. Is there anything else we need to know or be aware of for uploading backups?
No, that's it. Just do it, because we yep. have a lot of possibilities here, and if you don't do it, then it does not help, and that's most time is the cases of on-site installations that nobody cares about the backup until it's too late. Mm-hmm. So please think about it beforehand.
And your recommendation for regular backups and updates and whatever, what would your best practice be?
A best practice is do a backup mm-hmm. when you did the initial setup or if you changed something big.
Yeah.
Because it's not an ERP system or something, mm-hmm. it's a very static, a telephony system is a very static system. Okay. So at least you should create a backup if you did changes.
Something major.
Because everything you lose normally is CDR. So you lose who called whom mm-hmm. on the system, and maybe you lose something like a chat archive for a few days.
Okay.
So in most cases, this is not critical. But all the configuration work you did, all the users you mm-hmm. set up, all the call flows you set up, backup them.
Yeah. Okay. Good. There you have it. Right. So that's it for uploading, updating, and backing up your phone system. Until next time, thanks very much for watching.
Thank you. Bye.